Did you know that Klaviyo can track which customers open certain product pages? Hola everyone, Christian here. So we did a video on how to create a pop-up on Klaviyo, but this one, we are going to take a step back and show you how to connect Klaviyo with Shopify. And you wanna make sure you stick around to the end because we have some of the best practices and some of the things that you need to make sure that you're checkmarking when you're setting up your Klaviyo on Shopify. So there are two ways to get started. You can add the Shopify integration from the Klaviyo setup wizard, or you can add the Shopify integration from the integrations tab in Klaviyo. We're gonna do the second one, the latter. So integrate Klaviyo to your store. So we're gonna go over that second option. So if we go into our Klaviyo account right here, you'll see the integrations tab on the left-hand side. And then you wanna make sure that you search for Shopify in here. So Shopify, I'm gonna click add integration. And then all we need in here is the store URL. So this is gonna be the one that has the .myshopify.com. So I already have that over here. I'm gonna copy that and then paste it. Oops, I wanna make sure that we don't have that HTTP in there. There we go. Now, it should be already checkmarked, but you do wanna make sure that you have this one right here, right below that store URL that has automatically add Klaviyo on-site JavaScript, which is recommended. Now, if you have this checkbox, then that means that you don't have to add any other additional code or grab anything or mess around with any of that backend stuff. So highly recommend to do it this way. Here, they're gonna actually show you a few important settings, but if you ever you already ran through this and you wanna go back to it, you can by just going to the Shopify settings right over here within Klaviyo. So don't worry about if you already did this and you need to go back to it, you can. But we're gonna go over the collection of subscribers. So it's gonna give you a couple different channels in here, right? So collect email subscribers. So these are subscribers, contacts who opt in via Shopify during a checkout or with a Shopify footer form. So you see almost every store has that at the very bottom of the store, right? It has either, it says newsletter or like sign up to receive updates, and like people sign up and then it never ends up anywhere. So, and that's why, because they don't have this check mark right here. So it's very important to check mark that one and then actually select a list where you want them to go. So in this sense, we're just gonna do newsletter. And then the next one is collect SMS subscribers. And these are obviously for text messages. Again, something that we highly recommend that you do. And if you're not doing, start now. I'm gonna click on that. And then on this one, we have a specific list for SMS subscribers. And then that third check mark in here is the sync customers SMS subscription status to Shopify. So this says that Klaviyo will send an update to Shopify whenever a Shopify customer subscribes or unsubscribes to SMS. So very important. And then lastly, we have the advanced options. So this one is basically saying that this will update Shopify's customer profiles with Klaviyo data. So if a Shopify customer profile will basically be updated based on what's inside of Klaviyo. So Klaviyo will be sort of your main hub, right, for customer information. And it's because it's a little bit more powerful on what you can add and subtract, right, as far as customer data in order to, you know, send the right message to the right person. So again, I would highly suggest to do something like this. And then if you do sell products to the any customers in the European Union, you wanna make sure that you have that GDPR privacy requisites in place. So after all that is set up, we're gonna click on connect to Shopify here at the bottom. Now, before we move on, I just wanna say bienvenidos. My name is Christian Piñon, one of the co-founders here at Vibranding. We're an e-commerce growth agency that specializes in helping clothing stores grow and scale profitably online.
We drop new videos every week.
So you know what to do. You need to hit that subscribe button and turn on notifications so you don't miss out. So after hitting that button, you'll be brought into your Shopify store where you'll review the permissions and click install app. So we're gonna click on that. And this begins the syncing of your Shopify data with Klaviyo, and it takes you back to your Klaviyo account here. So as you can see here, we have confirmed the integration. Integrate. This will take a minute, but like I said, after integrating Shopify and having Klaviyo's on-site JavaScript added automatically, you won't have to do anything else. You can test this account if it's working on your Klaviyo account. Now in this dropdown right here where you see the store's name, you'll click on setup web tracking. Now, because we did the automatic JavaScript, we don't necessarily have to add this code. So I just input the URL right here, and then it says data received, continue. And it looks like we're good to go. Hey, if you like what you see, please consider liking. That will help us out a lot. Now, at the beginning of the video, I said or mentioned I said a question actually on whether or not you knew that with Klaviyo, you can actually track whether people view, you know, certain product pages. So for OS 2.0 themes, that's the sort of instructions I'm gonna give you here so that you know how to add this product snippet so that it tracks when your customers visit or view specific products on your website. So let's go over those right now. So inside of Shopify, you'll navigate to your theme. And then again, for this particular example, we're using Dawn. So it's a known OS 2.0 theme. So we're gonna click on customize. And then at the top of the page, you wanna click on that dropdown and click on products. And then you're gonna do the default product. And then on the left-hand side over here, we're gonna add a section. And when you click on custom liquid. Now in that custom liquid box right here, you want to copy the script, which I have in the description box below. You'll see a link to a Klaviyo help center page, and you will see the code in there. So I'm gonna copy that. And we're gonna paste it right here. We're gonna click on save. And now we have viewed product tracking to basically add it to all of our product pages. Now I wanna let you in a little secret. We're using a tool called Triple Whale for all of our clients and group coaching members. And this is a powerhouse because it allows you to see lifetime value for a customer at 30, 60, and 90 days. But what I'm most excited about is the estimated action of customers. Imagine being able to send out emails or run ads to customers who are likely to buy from you a second or third time and knowing when to send these out for your marketing messages, right? So it's super, super powerful. And you wanna make sure that you check out the link in the description below. Now that's all I have for today, guys. If you have any questions or comments about how to set up Klaviyo on your Shopify store, let us know down below. And make sure that you check out the next video on how to set up a Klaviyo pop-up.